Is it your first time seeing a doggy? Oh, okay, she's wrecking. Has she just robbed something? Did she just rob me? Welcome back to a brand new episode of Sim Spot in the Suburbs. I actually meant to record this earlier, and this was going to replace the Dream House, but then I got really scared about Clare and Ali dying, but then I checked using MCC, and they have 10 days left to live. Well, they have 9 now. So I figured we could still do some of the other series, still kind of see everybody else, but we're still going to get back for the end of the Clare and Ali life cycle, if you like. So today we are going to be in the suburbs, and there's going to be a birthday. Guess who it is going to be? Little Connor has been a child for quite a while now. I think it's about time we see what he is like as a teenager. So that's what we're going to be doing today. If you guys are excited, give this episode a little cheeky thumbs up. Let me know in the comments below. And let's play some Sims 4 in the suburbs. How weird is that? Listen, I've got like build and buy mode music. I don't know why. That's so weird. Okay, he wants to be a ninja. Find a ninja to train you, Connor. And I what is going on? Now I have two musics playing at the same time? What? I mean, it's nice. Like, I like having the music, but it's very weird to have. And also, why does nobody care for his dog while I'm out? The dog is literally gross. Okay, I don't know how to stop that music playing. I think I'm gonna have to go back to the world and then back again. I've never had the error before. It's really weird. It's still playing. You must be confused as well, because you can hear a voice, but you can't see us talking because I've got my camo top on, so I'm sorry about that, guys. It's still there. I'm gonna have to quit the game. What on earth? Okay, let's try this again. Fingers crossed we're not gonna have that really weird bug again. Okay. I think we're all good. I think we are all good. Good news, you guys. The bad news is it's 4 a.m. in the morning and you freaks are still all up. So please, can everybody get their little bots to sleep right now? I hate this business about them always being up and about when I get home. And then we're gonna have to look after the dog tomorrow, because otherwise someone's gonna take the dog away from us, because you guys suck at looking after him. Like, you literally suck. So you guys are saying that once Clare and Ali die, we'll have to age up some of the adults. However, James Calorie Aiken is the oldest of all of my children, and he is only 79 days old. Clare and Ali are 403 days old. So that's a pretty massive difference. And I kind of as well don't think they should be anywhere near looking old, like at least until Connor is an adult. So I think it would be a little bit premature to age them up already. So I'm not gonna be like rushing them into old age, if you feel me. Connor, I think you're meant to be at school, by the way. Yes, you are. Off to school with your butt, please. Look at him waking out of bed really, like you woken up and he's like, ah, I need to be at school. You know that panic you get when you like, just jump out of bed and realize you've completely missed your alarm. Look at little Charlie Rose's room still here. Looking amazing, and she's like stuck with her like rubbish room with the little baby and stuff. Actually, I think they should invite them around today. I think it would be nice for them to like see the little grandbaby and whatnot. Salma doesn't have work for 3 whole days. She's cooked a little fruit salad for everybody. When you grab some of the, oh wait, no. This is an old fruit salad. I only has an hour until it's spoiled. So when you finish that one, you need to pop that into the fridge and eat this one, okay? And then I think I might get her to go to the restaurant today, because, oh, and you need to give your poor dog some attention as well, because you need to get the perk where it like looks after itself. I really, really want to get it that, because then it will just kind of do its own thing, which is really good. And it means that when they do retire, they can just kind of easily retire and have the restaurant like looking after them. I told her to go to the toilet and she stood there panicking about the toilet instead of actually going. What even are you doing, Salma? Okay, Bruno, you're gonna have to wake up, my love, because you are gonna get, where's leashes him? Oh, she'd give him a kiss. Where is the whole leash thing? I want her to leash him so she can go for a jog for him, but I can't see the option. Oh, here we go. Okay, get him leashed up and then you're gonna go for a jog with him, Salma Rooney. There we go. Go for a jog. Off you go. Oh, she wanted to do that as well. She feels happy and inspired now she's done that. And then James Ickins, why don't you open up the, oh, the restaurant's, it's been open for 91 hours. Oops. At least we got loads of profit from it. Actually, literally, oh, we've got the gardener now too, you guys. She's sorting out everything here, which is good. Half of that profit is actually from when I got all the girly willies from Dream House to go to the restaurant. And they literally spent £1,000. It was pretty mad. We're really close to getting that well-managed perk as well. So I might reopen the business and get James to go there. He can work at it. He's got work at 3. So he'll just work at it for like an hour and a bit. And then little Salma Rooney can do a little trade with him. Oh, look, all the food that we were eating was still there. This is why they're in flirty moods, you know. The food that they were eating actually made them flirty. And the quality of it is excellent as well, which is really good. Okay, let's do a bit of cleaning up, Jamesykins. And we need to make sure all our staff are really good as well. We can get some of the people trained up a little bit as well. And we've promoted one of our chefs because he did really good. He's maxed out his cooking skills, so I feel like he deserves it. Gonna pay for a little bit of training with this guy here. Oh, James is headed to work and I've just left the restaurant. I did not realize he was going to work that soon. Okay, Salma, quick, quick. Okay, Salma's in here now and I'm recommended. Oh my gosh. It's so expensive here, like so expensive. It is actually unbelievable. But it's great because we're hopefully gonna make loads of money. I'm recommending like loads of really expensive dishes for people as well. I was kind of thinking, like, I never see Charlie Rose and Kira, you know, pop in to give us a little bit of support. But then I'm like, how could they possibly afford this place? However, Ali is here with random person, another elder. We'll have to keep a little eye in on him. And we've promoted one of our waiters as well, because he was still level 1, earning like $3 an hour, which it didn't feel right. It did not feel right. That's Max's dad, who also seems like you're on a little bit of a date. Why has this person got... Oh my gosh, I think this might be like a special reviewer or something. Okay, we need to prioritize them for sure. Look at this. I don't know if it's like, it must be a food critic. I'm promoting everyone today, by the way. I'm in a really nice mood. And I want to make sure that they're like happy with everything. She is, look, a restaurant critic. This is the first time we've ever had one. So we need to prioritize her food for sure. This guy looks like a celebrity as well. Our restaurant is the place to be, you guys. Okay, James is back. Salma's getting a little bit tired. The food critic's food is here. Oh, she's 5. She's got a 5-star. Okay, this could do really good things for us. Unfortunately, though, this guy here is like a little bit glitched. So he's like stuck on 3 stars and he won't order. So I'm kind of thinking I just reset him and him. There we go. I don't want it to be glitchy, you guys. Especially not when we've got a food critic. 5-star review. Genius is not a term I throw around lightly. This chef is genius, supported by excellent staff. The restaurant presented me with dishes I'd never imagined and flavors I wish I had. I'll be making my next reservation as soon as I get home. Dine here to take your taste buds to the next level. Why is she so angry? Flirty spouse. What? James isn't even here. What is going on? What is going on? Who is this Terry person? And why is she married to him? What the hell? Has she got... What the hell? Oh no, that's not her spouse. But then it also says it is her spouse. How can she be married to 2 people? I think that has glitched out. I am gonna forget that sim, because that's so weird. Salma has forgotten whoever this person is. That's because I've got it switched on where people can marry without me having to ask them. But I kind of assumed they would have to have a relationship before that happened. That seems stupid otherwise. Why would you just marry someone you've got no relationship with? Okay, everybody, I don't know why those guys are still there, but everybody else is out. It's 2 a.m. in the morning. I'm closing the restaurant. Oh my gosh, look at this. We've paid a lot of wages today. So even though we've got a lot of profit, like £3,000 worth of sales, our ingredients are expensive because we've got really good ingredients and we owe a lot of wages. So we actually only earned £1,000. I would say it's definitely not like the most profitable business, but it is an amazing restaurant and we're getting really close to that perk point. Like we're on 4,200, you guys. So that's really good. The restaurant is now closed. I mean, can I get it yet? What do I need? Oh! I'm so close, you guys. I'm gonna send her home. I'm so annoyed the games made her marry a random person. At least I fixed it. We'll pretend that never happened because that's stupid. I assumed that they would ask to marry people they actually had a relationship with, not just like random stupid person. I hate that, hate that. Oh my gosh, the gardener's been here all day, £90. I mean, I know there was a lot of stuff to sort out, but she's going a little bit crazy. I mean, she says she's all done, but she's still here spraying the bugs. I think you're all done now, lovely. Thank you. I don't know why the gardener dedication. She stayed there till 4 a.m. these guys did a little woo-woo together to put Selma in a better mood after her imaginary spouse made her angry. And little Bruno somehow got himself smelly again, and he was sleeping at the end of this one's bed. But he is now awake and ready for his day at school. So I'm kind of thinking, if I do age up him, little Connor, I'm probably going to have to do Abel and Erika quite close to him as well. Erika, I'll probably do today's episode as well. But Abel, I probably will do, I don't know whether to kind of break off Emma and Max into a separate series now that they're living together into like a revised broken dream. Although it would just be like, not a broken dream anymore. I don't know what I would call it. I just kind of feel like Abel and Connor should stay a similar age. Although I do feel like Connor is slightly older than him. So it's okay if we leave it a couple of days in between. I'm gonna get Selma to go for a jog. I don't know why she's wearing that for her jog. I thought she would jog to clear her mind, but you just got, you can't jog in a big coat. There you go, off you go. Whenever that gate there opens and closes, I always think it's a cat going but it's actually just the gate. You're late for school. Get your butt to school, young man. What is he even doing? That'll be the principal calling. And this one's looking much cleaner now. Also, I noticed that a lot of my families are disappearing off the gallery. So how can I, if I go in cast, I can add them to the gallery, can't I? So I'm just gonna start saving these households and adding them to the gallery for you guys, because they all just got deleted and I don't really know why. So they're on my gallery now. And what I've also done is shared it on my Facebook so I can grab the link and send it to you guys as well. Because I don't know why it deleted so many of the stuff that I uploaded. Like, I've had families on there for ages, like from when they were little kids, but they've all gone. So that should fix things. Oh my gosh, look how many comments. Look how many comments already. You guys are so awesome. There's like literally so many comments already. Oh, hello everyone. That's really cool. Oh, and she is literally still angry. Why do you invite around Gal Paldia to have a little vent to, okay? Don't send her an angry text. Invite her around so you can have, just kind of air your grievances with her, okay? And with James, I like to keep him like, I feel like he should keep fit and active because of his job. So I like to get him to like swim and run and jog and all that kind of thing, because you've got to be really fit to be a football player. Insult face. What? Okay, so she's got little Dia. Oh my god, is he wee? Oh my gosh! He just did poop inside! Can I chew him out for that? Scold him! That's disgusting. Okay, she's happy now. I think being around a friend has put her in a bit of a happier mood. Although, Dia, if you want to come and sit on the sofa instead of just stood in the hallway like a little bit of a weirdo, that would be great. So there we go. This is one way to get back into a good mood. With your girly-whirly friends. Look at her knees, by the way. They've got a lot of texture going on her knees there. She's got a bit of a detailed skin. But she's never going to be Selma-style gorgeous, is she? Selma's probably the most beautiful Sim in the whole game. And I didn't even make her. She was just a townie. These guys are having a little catch-up, which is nice. Is James still doing his laps? Oh, he's just finished and he's just about to go cook some mac and cheese. Why don't you cook something that everybody can eat as well? Clean out the gross food and then serve lunch so Dia can eat with us too. Do clam chowder. I don't know if you're going to be any good at it, but give it a go. And they need to take their Christmas decorations down. We've still got ours up downstairs. I think you keep them up for the first week of January and then you take them down. James has reached cooking level 10 as well. And look at him making his little clam chowder outside. Why don't you call everybody to have some? Look at his bod still. That is what you get from being a pro football player, you guys. You get a very good bod. Good old James. Look at that. He's even got... Oh, I thought you were cooking clam chowder. You've cooked a steak instead. Well, I guess if you're a football player, you kind of need the big meals. So I'll let you off. Your restaurant has started to lose money. What? Why is it starting to lose money? And my perk points aren't going up either. And she's still in a foul mood. James, do you have work today? You have work in 2 days. Okay, as lovely as you're being at home, I think I'm going to have to make you travel to the restaurant and fix things, okay? Which is annoying because I wanted to invite Charlie Rose around tonight. So I'm going to have to invite her around tomorrow night instead. Or maybe I'll just invite her around when we see the birthday party. Maybe she comes around a little bit earlier so we can spend some time with little Noelle. Because I feel like they're her grandparents. They would definitely want to spend a lot of time with her. Especially because they know how much help Charlie Rose needs. Okay, James, as great as you look, I don't think you should wear that to the restaurant. Let's get super smart, okay? There you go, get into your suit. I've just realized as well, I said I was gonna get some music in here and then I just never did. So I think we definitely need some music. And then I also said that I didn't think this had been finished off, and it hasn't, so I need to do this too. There we go. That's better. Okay, so we've got nice romantic music playing in here as well now. And we're so close to being able to afford those perk points. Another food critic, you guys. In fact, isn't that the same lady as last time? Or do they just all wear the same top? Oh my gosh, you guys, finally, we can afford it. Well managed. Finally, that's taken so long. Okay, I don't want to be working as late tonight, so I'm going to disallow new customers now, and then I'm going to make sure this lady gets well looked after. Oh, it's night-night at the bar. You want to check it out? I thought you were hanging out with my wife, dear. And I can't. I'm in the restaurant. I'm sorry, lovely. Another 5-star review. Dining here was one of the most remarkable experiences of my life. It's opened my mind to what perfection could really be. The flavors of my meal will linger with me for years to come. You should probably brush your teeth more then, friendo. Down here, it's not a suggestion, it's a Monday. That's really good again, you guys. Okay, I think we're just about done with the restaurant. We just need this lady here to leave and then we are all done. Like my nice relaxing, romantic music. Very chill. Okay, time to close the restaurant for another day. We made really good profits today. Everyone's like really good and seems really happy. I'm wondering if I can spend any money like advertising. I might just pay for a little bit of advertising, especially now that we're getting those good reviews. And I'm gonna also make everything local, GMO free and freshly harvested. There we go. So those guys are gonna have their work cut out for them, but we don't need to be there to manage it as much anymore, which is great. Okay, I question the parenting when I come home and they're both playing with this. At 12:30 a.m. in the morning. I mean, that's not really what I was looking for there in the whole parenting thing, Selma. So if you could just not next time, that would be great. Connor's already doing very mediocrely at school. He's never got above a grade C. And he hasn't even done his homework for the evening. So I'm getting her to clear away all the food. Everybody just needs to get to bed, you know? And then it's the final day at school to like improve his grades. We've still got a room that hasn't been used here, by the way. But it's the final day at school to improve his little grades before he ages up. He adults up, I was gonna say, but he won't, he'll be a teenager. And then we probably need to update his room a little bit as well, because it's a very kiddie room, isn't it? I wonder if he's gonna be quite sporty like James is. I kind of feel like he will be. Okay, so this one's up and he's having steak for breakfast. Can you actually instead fill your pet bowls for your pet dog, please? And then do you have some homework in your inventory you should be doing? Yes, you do. You can breeze through your homework. Like, you're not a stupid kid. But you need to just actually do your homework. Forget your steak breakfast. What would you think you are? You are in Chef Selma's house, to be fair. Selma's like, aren't you meant to be at school, kiddo? Please get your butt to school, kiddo, on her very cushiony little pillow. So his homework's done and he's heading into school. I don't think he's ever gonna be a grade A student, so I'm not too worried about that. The gardener says we don't need her services today. You know what that means, Selma? What the hell? I've been thinking maybe opposites attract. Let's go for breakfast. Let's not, Alicia. Bye, Alicia. And I'm gonna buy some seeds to plant in the garden. Which ones do you reckon? I don't really care about any of those seeds. Have I got some nice stuff to plant already? Or I could plant a few chrysanthemums, you know? That would be quite nice. Spend a little bit of time planting those. I don't think you've got... Have you got work today? You've got work in 3 hours. Okay, just plant a few of these and then get ready for work, you bears. Actually, you know what? We don't need the money today. And I kind of want to see little Noelle. So I think I'm actually gonna go ahead and take a vacation day. James, you may take a vacation day too. Look at that, straight away he's like, yes, vacation day. And then one thing I was kind of thinking is I quite want to get, so Bruno is like our boy golden retriever. I was gonna try and get, I was thinking another golden retriever, but like a red one, and get a girl dog. And then maybe we can have some little puppies. Let me know what you guys think of the idea. I think it could be quite fun. I've never had puppies before in The Sims 4, so I'm intrigued to see how it goes. He was thinking about babies then. No thinking about babies, James, okay? And they're gonna invite around Charlie and Noelle to come and hang out. Noelle, I've never had a kid like anything like the name Noelle. I quite like it. Still getting MCC Evers, you guys! Okay, I wanna see her like toddling towards the door, looking adorable. Okay, Charlie Rose is here? Where is your child? Where actually is your child? She's off to go hug her. There she is, you guys. Oh my gosh, let's peek through one of these. Oh my gosh. How cute is she? Look at her. Adorable. Please don't slam the door on her. In you go. There you go. I'll get down to your level. Look, a doggy, Noelle. What do you think? Is it your first time seeing a doggy? Oh, okay. She's wrecking. Is she just robbed something? Did she just rob me? Oh my god, Bruno's afraid of the door? Why is he getting all these really weird things wrong with him? Let's calm him down and find out what's wrong with him. What's wrong, Bruno? I think he's okay. He seems pretty happy. Oh, then Grandma Bear's having a little chit-chat away with very cute, cute little Noelle with her cute little chubster legs. I love my little squishy toddlers. Oh my god. For a minute then, I thought, why is Jamie Street in a house? Because the outfit James has got on. James, you've been very confusing there. And why are you just singing? It's just singing to everyone. Oh my god, it's done the trick on her. I think he's actually, like, serenading her. Wow. Not the time, you guys! Well, now she's very flirty. Oh, so they're chit-chatting away with cute little Noelle. I don't know where Charlie is, but they seem to be keeping her quite entertained. Oh, Charlie's back. And Charlie's come to come and hang out with them as well. You know what? Charlie's looking good, you guys. I definitely think she's lost a little bit of the baby weight that she picked up. And she is definitely starting to look a little bit more like the Charlie that hung around the house, isn't she? Oh my god, she wants to woo-woo. That's what mood stupid James has got her in. And look, they've got this playroom that was originally for, like, Connor and Charlie Rose. Go away, MCC. But it's now kind of cute for Noelle, don't you think? Okay, so little Connor Rooney is back. He's met Robin as well. So he's got a few cute little child friends. I kind of think he should invite them round for, like, his little birthday party at home. In fact, we should probably put some little balloons and stuff up for him, shouldn't we? Oh my god, we had these exact ones when he was, aging up from a baby to, like, a toddler, and then a toddler to a child. And now we've got them again. I know they're kind of phasing in with the Christmas decorations a little bit, but we want to make it extra party, don't we? Connor's always been a spoilt one. Pops them outside the house, that everybody coming into the house knows it's Connor's birthday. There we go. It's looking very birthday-fied from the outside. This is good. You always do that when you've got kids. You get, like, the little balloons and stuff for them. Okay, so I think you need to invite round all the kids your age and Lilith and stuff. Actually, we'll do, like, a big group gathering, but I just want him to spend a little bit of time with, like, kids first. Like, having a little bit of a play. Wait, where's that girl that he gets on really well with? Why is she not on this list? Erika. You need to invite Erika around as well. Oh, she already here. Did you bring her home from school? Okay, so all his little friends around, including his little cousin, Faith. It's got a little pool party going on. It's only 4 p.m, so they've got quite a bit of time to, like, play together. In fact, Salma's called everyone for this food, but I don't know if there's going to be enough of it for everyone, considering we've got a house full of little kids at the moment. We did invite Ryder, but he's not come inside. He's just, like, hanging out here, hitting himself in the face accidentally with his butterfly. He's just not really, it's a little bit different from Connor, I would say. So all his cute little friends, including the new girly-whirly he met at school today. She's cute. She is super cute. That's little Robin Belcher. Belcher is a little bit of an unfortunate surname. We've got Abel around here as well. We've got Christian. Do you remember Christian? One of his original friends as well. The only one that I can't get to come round is Erika. Like, it says she's here. But I can't. Oh, she's there! Okay, she's there. She's playing in the pool. She's playing in the pool there. Little Erika, who I'm gonna age up to. Look, straight away he wants to go and chat with her. Look at her with, like, her little shades on. Oh my god, the trees. The tree is messing with me right now. How cute and cool is Erika? Look how badass she looks. And she swam her way over to him. That's quite clever. He's hanging out on top of here. It's a little bit of a lonely way to spend your birthday, Connor. You need to chat with people. Oh, look, now he's doing a little bit of teasing of her. She's in a bit of a bad mood, though, so I don't know how well that's going to go down. Like, look at her eyebrows. She's mad. Although I think Connor's cheering her up. Connor and his ways. I was going to say his feminine wills, but obviously not. He's trying to cheer her up. He knows that she's stressed. That's what the broken pencil means. Okay, so little cutie pie Noelle has had to go home because it's a little bit late. So she's probably getting looked after by, like, Anthony. This MCC thing's really bugging me. But I'm going to start gathering and get everybody to come round. We probably need to remove Jay from the group, don't we? At least everybody is round to see Connor age up. And these little cutie pies outside. Well, still in a very, very flirty mood. But everybody should be coming around to the house now to hang out. There they go. At least we've got Taylor and Jay. The thing is, I can't remove them from the group. Look at these two little troublemakers. It has to be Emily that removes them. And Charlie Rose is doing a little bit of cleaning for us there. Oh, and look, everyone's come to like watch him like do his little monkey bars and stuff. Do you see James's hair then? Okay, Christian, you're boring. You've left far too early. But look at Connor. He's like literally like a little... Oh, I was going to say he's like a little monkey, but then he fell. But he's still pretty good, you guys. Look at all this business. Careful. Careful, Connor. You're making me really, really nervous, okay? Oh, and Ryder's playing with him. Those guys are little cousins, so that's cute. Jay, you're not really part of the group anymore, friendo. Not really part of the group anymore, okay? Look at these two. How much browner is Connor than Ryder as well? I think he's going to be quite an athletic kid. Don't fall again. You're making me very scared on there. But James is super athletic, and I kind of just feel like Connor will be too. Okay, Salma, let's get you to cook a birthday cake. I think Connor would quite like a chocolate cake. And everyone's just having a nice chit-chat and hang out. I am going to make her blow out the candles of the cake too. Max is here as well. I don't know where Emma and Emily are. Oh, and these two are conveniently sat next to each other. Be careful, you two, okay? Be very careful, bopping your heads in perfect time to the music. I see you. Oh my God, I come back and half the freaking cake has been eaten, for God's sake. I need to do it again now. Okay, these guys seem to be getting on a little better too. You'd have thought that would make him angry, but he is much better at keeping the whole work flirtation under control than she is. It's got quite nice vibes for the birthday, actually, with James for some reason doing little press-ups on the floor. There's like nice music playing. I love the group thing because everyone just hangs out and has a really nice time together, but I need to keep an eye on Salma because of the cake. I really don't want anybody to eat this before I get a chance to put the candles on it this time. Okay. Nobody's touching that cake. Add the birthday candles right now, Salma. No dancing, okay? Quick! Someone will take a slice. Ryder, I see you. I see you eyeing it up, okay? There we go. So, now we need little Connor Rooney to go ahead and blow out the candles, Connor, because you are becoming a teenager. I'm going to keep his hair the same as well. And I'm just like really excited to see how he's going to look. Go on. What, can you not get to it? Is there too many people? Is everybody getting a little bit crowded for you, Connor? Have you found yourself a nice safe place to blow out the candles? Okay, here we go. He's sat on the chair and he's off the chair. And he's lost. He is so lost. He's very bonny though, isn't he? There you go. Candles are blown out. And Connor has aged up. Okay, so he's keeping his dog lover. What should we make his pure aim in life? I kind of want to make him the serial romantic. And then we might do a Max thing where if he completes a serial romantic trait, we will allow him to unlock the soulmate trait. But only if he completes this one, okay? Let me know what you guys think about that. I think we kind of make him a little bit of a bad boy in that regard. And then to help him out with that, I'm also going to make him a romantic sim as well. Oh no, game. Game, what have you done? Why have you killed him? He is dead. He is so dead. Okay, we need to instantly change that. And then I am going to get him to just put some birthday candles on top of it again so that we can age up Erika afterwards. Although I don't know where she is. Okay, nobody can eat the cake, which is good. And then let's do a little bit of a update of Connor Rooney, who you guys like a lot. But are you gonna like him when he breaks the hearts of teenage girls across the whole of the Simland? That is the question. Okay, so it's kept his skin the same, but what it hasn't done is updated the color. And Connor was definitely like, what was he? Maybe about like there or there? He was definitely a little bit of a darker skinned sim. In fact, I think we looked at Salma for inspiration because he's got a really similar skin tone to Salma. I think at the moment it's a little bit like a little bit too dark and a little bit too reddy. We need to get him the same one as he was before. I might have to look at my original video to find it. And I don't want him to have like the wrong skin tone. That one has boobs. And also, if you remember, Connor had little gentle freckles. I'm sure he did. Like, let me just turn him into a kid, just again, for 1 second. Because then I can see what he was before. Yeah, he had those. He definitely had freckles across his nose, didn't he? Okay. Right, I'm going to have to take off the ridiculous hair and the heart. He's just going to have to be bald while I fix him. So he needs his little frecklerinos back on. I think that one's quite good. That one's pretty good. Oh my gosh, his skin color is completely different to James's. It's quite funny. I like it. I like the variation. What was James's skin detail? Okay, he's got this one here. Let's see what Connor looks like with the same one. Sorry if this is boring, but the skin details you put on, like, so much decide how he looks. It's pretty important. Okay, I think we're getting closer. The good news is I can already tell he's really good looking. Like, he's a good looking Sim. Just gonna give him the right eyes, because I use the new style eyes now. And I think they're about right for Connor, because he was that before, which is probably that. Although I did actually give him these eyes. So they're the ones you're used to on Connor, but they're like the eyes that I'm switching to now. And I prefer them. I think they just look a little bit better. Okay, so he's got his eyelashes on. And then we definitely need to do something about these eyebrows. So I know exactly which eyebrows Connor had. He had these ones before, but they look quite a different shape on him now he's older, but they are the eyebrows. I promise you they are the eyebrows he had, because I just looked at the video. And then we obviously know what hair we're gonna give him. We can change him later down the line, but Connor's hair is like Connor's hair. Is Connor's hair. Okay, now he's starting to look a lot more like our little Connor Rooney, isn't he? There is a version of this hair that has like this. Oh, I think it looks at, yeah, it was that color. It was that color. He was a little bit darker, but then that one has like the thing shaved into the side of his head. Which is kind of quite like badassy hair, but they don't have it for the color that we use, which is really annoying. Like, why do only some of them get the shaved bits in? Because I feel like he would do that. Could only do it if we completely darkened his hair. Although I'm kind of thinking that because boys and girls, actually, boys and girls, but if you're blonde as a kid, you tend to go a little bit darker as an adult. I did that. So it would be from this to this. But maybe we don't do it straight away. Maybe he stays his natural blonde for a little bit, and then over time, we can both give him slightly darker hair, and then maybe give him just a... Oh, maybe not the full beard. Give him just a little bit of scrub at the side of his face as well, like this. Just an idea. A little bit of a scrubberoonie around his face. But for now, I'll keep him the same way he was when he was a kid. He's cute. He's really cute. We could make him look like a proper little bad boy. But I don't think he's quite cries in Spanish. I don't think he's quite there yet. I don't know why it says cries in Spanish, but that's actually hilarious. We could maybe give him it for his sport outfit. Okay, so now let's look at his clothes. Oh my gosh. Why have they made him so like, in the UK we would say like, it's like private school, but in the US I think you say public school. It's one or the other way around, but basically grammar school paid for kind of schooly. I don't know why they made him like that, because he was like really like streetwear-y before. And I think I need to make sure he keeps the same style. At least initially. Ooh, he's excited. He's like, ooh, what does this mean? See, I love this so much, but who is it that wears that all the time? Asha. Asha always has that on. I've got these new just like little hoodies as well. I think one of you guys linked me on Twitter. I think they're quite cool, but maybe not a day-to-day one. We've got like the big baggy sort of jumpers, which I quite like. Although the texture on them is awful. Oh my gosh, look at these. Oh my gosh, he would definitely be breaking my heart. I quite like those, and it's like showing off a little bit of him here too. He is meant to be a little bad boy, you guys remember. Oh my gosh, this one shows off even more. I think him and Abel should get tattoos. He's a good looking lad, isn't he? Got this little jumper too. Actually, I've got quite a lot of new clothes for boys. I knew he was aging up, so I got ready, you guys. I like that jumper. And then there's these like, I can kind of see him wearing this, you know? Like, what is that? Baseball? Baseball-y kind of tops? That's cool, I like that. Maybe like that kind of a thing? I don't know. I don't know, because American style and UK style is so different. And I kind of feel like they're a little bit American style-y, these guys. Like, those pants are American style too. That's so American-y. Like, to me as an English person, that looks super American. Really American. I'm trying to find, like, you know, like the dropped pants, because he wore those as a kid. So I think maybe initially at first he should keep them on. I'll become a pirate. Okay, I'm gonna keep him in those just for now. And that's new as well. I've got loads of new stuff, you guys. And I might just put him in this as well. And it clips a little bit on his shoulders. I don't know if it's cause he's like, he's thin. Like, look at him, he's thin. But then he's kind of like in between buff and not buff. But I kind of feel like this matches how he dressed when he was a kid. And I kind of want to keep that. I might change the... This is cool because I like layer it on. I might change the color to something a little bit darker. Yeah, I like that. And I feel like that matches how he dressed when he was a kid. So it kind of goes. I need to get him some like Yeezys, don't I? I'm just going to do that with him for now. And then his formal outfit is definitely not going to be that. Why has he got a pair of flares on? Okay, formal, I'm going to go with that. And then sports. This is where I want to put like his little hoodie on and stuff. Or maybe like this. Oh my gosh, yes, let's do this. Okay, little workout gear. I can imagine him kind of liking his weights and stuff, you know? Why would you wear that to bed, game? That is nonsense talk. You can wear that to bed, though. I can deal with that. What? Game, what are you even thinking? What have you taken? My mouth just went... Okay, so for party wear, I just put him in this little Jack and Jones sort of... bit more of a tight fit and, you know, show the goods kind of jumper. And then this is his, like, little swimwear. So I just gave him some little shades. I think he looks pretty cool. He's very hairless, I'm just noticing. I need to give him some hair. It'll be blonde, but still. He probably only have... I just don't like it when they don't have hair on their arms and legs. So I think that looks a little bit more realistic. Okay, so there he is with his little glasses on. However, let's just get up close and personal with his face. So there is our little Connor Rooney with his, like, little Supreme on. I think he looks cool. I think he looks really cool. Does he look like the kind of guy that would break hearts? Because that's what you guys wanted him to be. And that's kind of what he is going to be since he has the romantic heartbreaker, but still loves dogs. He'll break your heart, but he won't, like, break your dog. So, you know, I think he's a nice looking Sim. He's definitely still got that, like, very sort of cuteness from his youth. But now he's just a little bit more grown up. That clipping is annoying. I think it's because maybe he's got, like, quite a thickish sort of neck. But Selma and James have done good. So we've got daytime, formal, sports, nighttime, party wear, and swimwear. Let me know what you guys think of Le Connor Rooney. Let's listen into the world. And then I also just need to quickly age up Erika. I don't know whether to age up, like, his little... friend group in general, so you know that he's at least got a few older, a few people his age around him. He's got, like, I kind of feel a bit sad for Erika because he's got this whole, like, heartbreaker thing. Oh my god, is he just in his he's in his swimwear, obviously, because he was in the pool. And just look at him, like, posing around. James is all, like, happy and joyous. I was super happy about him, and he's just like, yeah, what? Yeah, what are you gonna do? I'm so cool. I'm Connor Rooney. Oh, and Salma's giving Bruno some attention on the sofa. But where is all the other kids? But I feel a little bit sorry for Erika. Maybe she's the one girl he never gets with that ends up being his true love, and he's just breaking hearts across the rest of the place instead. Where are his friends? How am I supposed to age up his friends if I can't find them? I might have to get them all to come around tomorrow instead, and then I'll be able to age them up. I need to be careful, though, because I can't advance too far in time, because, oh my god, we're gonna have to age up his age up. We're gonna have to make his room look a little bit more grown up in the next episode as well, because this just does not look right for a child, for a teenager, does it? But you know, your room doesn't put Erika to bed? Put Erika to bed? That means Erika's here? Oh, put Erika to bed. In what is probably the weirdest interaction. He won't do it. Where is she? Is Erika, like, glitched out somewhere? She's apparently at our house, but I can't see her anywhere. I'm, like, peeking through all the windows. So for his serial romantic, he has to at first have a boyfriend or girlfriend, and then he needs to go on 2 dates. And his reward will be a player. Players will never cause Sims to get jealous no matter what they do. Your Sim wants to play the field and go on dates with all kinds of interesting people. Where is Erika? That is my question to you. Okay, so he's woken up flirty. I'm gonna invite Erika around just to age her up, which is really weird because it's like he's messaging, like, a kid to come around and he's older and flirty. All very weird. I am gonna age her up before she even gets inside the house. That's how efficient we are. Okay, so that's her mum. And then here is little Erika. She's a social butterfly and a perfectionist. Well, now she's a teenager. And I don't really like, I need to get some more aspirations. I don't really feel like there's quite enough. But maybe Erika wants to be, maybe Erica's the kind of Sim that wants a family, which is why she doesn't really work with Connor as he is right now. You see where I'm going with this? She's a perfectionist. I think we make her cheerful as well. She was a little bit tricksterish as a kid though, but there's no trickstery one to give her. No, like, mischievous one, is there? Besides, I think she was only mischievous because Connor was. Okay, so I've given her the same skin type she had as a child, which was, like, the softness skin. And then her eyes are the wrong shade as well, because she had these eyes. And she had a little eye. These eyelashes are, like, freakishly long. But I kind of like them. I do like them. Okay, so we've got her, like, we need to sort out her eyebrows. Mind you, they are going to be that color, aren't they? Because she had red hair. I wish she could sort hair by like new, because I'd like to give her, I've downloaded quite a lot of new hair as well, and I'd quite like to give her like a new hairstyle. That's kind of similar to what she had as a kid. Oh, she's so cute. Nope. No one can get away with that hair, can they? Oh, wow. She looks good with that hair. Oh, it doesn't have the right shade though. I guess that kind of is. I feel like she's a little bit redder. Maybe she has a little pixie hair. She's kind of cute. We don't have any girls with really short hair. Let me know if you'd like that idea. That one's got weird shading around the front. That looks pretty. Oh, I don't know, guys. I don't know what to give her. I kind of like that, actually. Like, she looks like a little bit more of a sensible girl. Oh my gosh, I've got some crazy makeups. Oh my gosh, imagine if you could actually get eyeliner in real life that was that colourful. Okay, I just think quite simple makeup like that is really pretty on her. She's so cute. I kind of like that she's still, like, really young looking. And I also like that she's, like, kept, like, really Asian looking features. I think that's really cool. Okay, I'm not going to do any more on her. I'm not going to waste loads of time. But I kind of feel like she'd have quite a preppy sort of like she's a good girl sort of style. So maybe not that. Okay, I think I'm just gonna give her these like little genie beanies and like this little jumper. She's got such a good butt. Everyone's got such good butts. She, oh my God, you know what she is? She's Mini Salva. Somehow James has found himself, get yourself a woman that looks like your mother apparently. That's what he's gone ahead and done. Oh my gosh, she's got quite a pretty formal outfit, but not very teen. So I'm just gonna swap her out to this, which I think is a little bit more teen. And also swap her hair like down. She's so cute. She is so cute. Little running outfit. That's the ugliest dressing gown I have ever seen, friendo. Head! Party, okay. Oh my gosh, why did you suddenly get your little tum-tums out for parties, eh? I see what you're doing. What's this? Oh, I like that. I want it in real life. It is quite Lily Bear though, but I think she gets away with it as long as she wears it in white. And I think Lilith would probably wear it with tights, whereas I feel like she would want to wear it with little leggings. She's not as cheeky as Lilith. She's not running around with Jamie Street, you know? There we go. And what makeup has it put on her? Oh my God, what is going on with your eyes, my love? Okay, you can put a little bit of makeup on when you've got your party gear on. I quite like that makeup. I like cooler makeup on like the monolidded like Asian style eyes. I think you can have a bit more fun with her eyes. Oh, she looks so pretty. Man, I enjoy this bit of it too much. I love making Sims. Look how different those two looks are. She's got like kind of, she's got like a model face where you can do anything with it because it looks so different. She's like a chameleon. A chameleon? A chameleon. I quite like that look. That looks cool. Why did your hair go a different color in the pool, my love? That's better. Oh my gosh. You're going pretty insane on the bikini there. I've got some nice like new swimsuits. How cool is that one? Look at these. I just don't know if they're a little bit naughty for her. Ooh. That one's probably the least so. I think that's really pretty. Like if I took her hair off, you'd be able to see it a little bit more. You're gonna go bald for a minute, but look how pretty that is. I would totally wear that, it's so nice. No makeup on at the pool. Okay, I'm spending loads of time on a sim that might not even end up in the main series, so I need to stop. But I think she looks very, very goody-goody and very cute. And I like her a lot, so let me know what you guys think about her as well. She's just about to head out to go and hang out with Connor all weekend. We're not going to be there to see it because we're not going to be playing Suburbs this weekend. We're going to be going to another series. And we need to make sure that Clare and Ali don't do and die on us. So, you know, wow, 2 hours, 10 minutes I've been recording for. That's what happens when you make Sims. Okay, guys, so there we look how polite and nice they are. The thing is, he's woken up flirty. So he's probably going to end up trying to flirt with it. He's still got all his birthday stuff on as well. We'll need to get rid of that. But there we go, you guys. Both of these little cheekies aged up. Is it just me or is she quite tall? Why is she so tall? I didn't accidentally make her an adult, did I? No, she is definitely a teen. She's just quite tall. Oh, and he's so flirty. Is she flirting back? No, I think they're just chit-chatting away. But there you go, you guys. These little cutie pies are both teenagers now. Is it just me or is she being really flirty with him? I was not expecting that, but let me know what you think about their designs in the comments below. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this episode of In the Suburbs, and I'll see you guys in another video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye. I'll leave these two as well because I don't know where it's going. I do not...